beyond the app servers, we had our database. Now, we just talked about how kind of the funky database setup we had, but it was still Postgres. And we'll still use the industry standard cylinders for representing our databases. And these were, you know, we had a couple verticals. I think we stored links on one, votes on another, comments were on one. And then we had like a miscellaneous one. Did we store subreddits and users on the same one or something like that?
Subreddits were with comments, users were with links.
When we first built the system, it was all on one machine, and we had different tables for each data type. And so a natural way to grow was just split apart the data types. Because remember, I talked about how if you don't do joins, scaling is a lot easier. This is an example of that. You know, you have to think a little bit harder about what your queries are going to be, but you can start splitting things apart. Do you know how many comments are in the comments database now?
Something on the order of like 250 million.
250 million comments. When I left, God, I don't remember how many. It was a lot. And it wasn't fitting on one machine, you know, with links and that. All of these databases were replicated. We used Londist, I think. Do you guys still use Londist?
Yes, we do.
Yeah, Londist. Londist is a third-party tool made by...
Skype,
yeah, yeah. The Skype guys, and basically what this does is, I think it does log shipping, right?
No, so when you write to the master, it hits a trigger, which then inserts the same query into a queue, and that's replicated to all the slaves. The same inserts are run on all the slaves.
Okay, so it actually replays the exact commands.
Yeah, obviously like things like random get pre-calculated.
Okay. So all of these machines were replicated using Londist. And Londist is really cool. And it might be Londiste, I don't know. That's the problem with web technologies, right? You read about the technology, and like, I don't know. Some people I think call this Ha proxy. But it's the first guy in the office who discovers the piece of technology. He gets to decide how it's pronounced for the rest of the company. We replicate all of these machines, both for durability. You know, so if we lost a machine, you know, we wouldn't lose our data. Mm-hmm. I mean, on Reddit, if we lost your comment history, you'd be mad. And for load, we'd spread our reads across all these machines. Now, remember we talked about replication lag, and I learned this lesson the hard way, and it was really hard for me to figure that out the first time because I had never heard of replication lag. We had really subtle bugs as a result.